Hi guys, welcome to another Tea Time Show. This is the regular show where we share lots of strategies and tips to help you grow your business online. Make sure you subscribe for more updates, and if you have questions, make sure you ask in the comments and we'll try and cover them, or maybe do another show just for you. So today's question comes from Louisa, and Louisa asks, how do I measure my Twitter impact? So how do I measure the success? What metrics should I be using, I guess? So the first thing to remember about Twitter as a social platform, it is what we call top of funnel activity. That is to say that is brand activity, about building relationships and reputation for yourself as an individual, or for your brand, depending on how you're using Twitter. So that conversely isn't really about direct sales. So make sure you're using Twitter for the right thing in the first place. So the first point is to focus on meaningful metrics. So the metrics that mean something to your brand. So you shouldn't really be thinking, how many sales do I get from Twitter? How many sales does Twitter influence? Absolutely, you should maybe consider that. But the more meaningful metrics that will lead to ultimately to sales are reach, engagement, and maybe clicks through to your profile or clicks through to your website through the links that you share on Twitter. Don't worry too much about how many followers you have. Way too many people focus on that on Twitter. It's more of an ego trip than actually a value. The first few I mentioned in that list, so reach and engagement, will automatically build followers. Which will increase the amount of engagement, which increases reach, which increases followers, and so it goes on. So focus very much, Louisa, on reach and engagement, and think about clicks. So how do we measure that impact? So the first place to look is in Twitter's analytics itself. So if you go to analytics.twitter.com, you will find a dashboard very similar to this one that gives you lots of lovely data about the performance of your Twitter account. And as you can see here, there are lots of green arrows based on the performance over the previous period. So that's great. So how many times did I tweet? How many impressions? So how many times have my tweets actually been displayed to users on Twitter? So that's up a nice number, up over 200,000 now. How many people have visited my profile? How many times have I been mentioned? And how many followers have I gained? Remember, don't get caught out too much on that one. And then we can see a whole heap of data about what my top tweet is, my top mention, how many engagements, top follower that I've gained, you know, those sorts of things. And then I can see a March summary. If I scroll down, I can see the whole of February. There's my tweet impressions for the whole of February, which is pretty good considering I nearly hit that in March. So that's good. How many mentions, how many profile visits. So I can compare almost month on month to see that I'm improving. So that's the first place to look. We can dive deeper into this data by clicking on tweet activity here. So this would be for March. So let's dive straight in there. The link's also at the top of the screen here. And this will give you more detail about individual tweets and also the performance. And you can change the date range here as well. So let's look at February's data. Okay, and then we can see at the moment we're just looking at all tweets. We can also look at top tweets. So these are the things that we've had the most impressions or the most engagements, things like that. And then the engagement rate as well. What we're really interested in is overall, probably, rather than individual tweets. It's very difficult to replicate the performance of a particular tweet. So, you know, don't think, you know, well, this tweet had greater impact because it had an image. That may be possible. It may be that actually somebody with a big following just happened to retweet that particular one, and that's why it had a big reach. It could have been any number of factors. So replicating the circumstances of a precise tweet that performed very well in the past is very difficult. You can look and analyze some trends over a period of time and see if video or maybe images or particular hashtags have worked very well for you, and then see how much engagement that you got from those and maybe replicate that a bit more. One thing is certainly true. If I have a look at my tweets that get the most engagement, they tend to be within Twitter chats. Now, there's a whole Twitter chats list. I'll put a link in the description of the video for you so you can see that. And there are literally hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of Twitter chats broken down by location, by category, by topic, those sorts of things. And if you find one or two that are relevant to you, you'll find the engagement rate is very high in those. A lot of people generally sort of listening and having conversations. So that tends to work very well, and it will help increase your reach and your engagement, and also following them and people following you back with people who are relevant to you and to your business, your product, or your service. So Twitter chats is a great way to increase your engagement, certainly if you're fairly new to Twitter. We do have, by the way, a great, fantastic resource. Again, I'll put a link in here for you. A fantastic resource on how to use Twitter for business. A whole heap of videos just like this one that will help you kind of get to grips with the terminology, how to increase your reach, your engagement, how to kind of compose a tweet, how to find people you follow. All that stuff is in there. So I'll share a link to that, and you're welcome to have that. It's completely free. So engagement rate, 1.6% is pretty good. How many link clicks I had, how many retweets, how many people have liked my tweets, and how many replies I've got. And these are the metrics really that are important. Obviously, some of these kind of create the others. If you are creating more engaging tweets, then your engagement rate will increase. If your engagement rate increases, then link clicks and retweets and likes will also increase, as will replies. If you are engaging more in Twitter chats or using the right hashtags, then more people will see your tweets. So the reach increases, and therefore the number of engagements should also increase. Not necessarily the percentage, but the number of engagements, the number of link clicks, the number of retweets, the number of likes, they should naturally increase as well. So think about these percentages, they are very important. But bear in mind, when you have a small amount of reach and a fairly small number of engagements, that you could get a really high skewed percentage. So those percentages work better when you've got a bigger audience and a bigger reach. You will find if you go buying Twitter followers, just seriously don't bother, it's not worth it. But if you go and buy followers, almost inevitably your engagement rate, your reach, the number of impressions, those sorts of things is going to be much, much lower than if you earn those and they're people that you've genuinely connected to, and that you're working with. So, that are familiar to you. So, we can kind of slice and dice all of this data. I'd recommend just going having a dive around in here, Louisa. Look at some stats. Look at your tweets and replies, your tweets, your top tweets. Look at them over a period of time. Look at just going back to here. Look at where you've had the most engagement or the top mentions. Try and engage with those people that are engaging and engaging an audience. And join in with those conversations is a good way to kind of build your presence as well. But make sure they are relevant to your business and that their audience is relevant to your business. No point in hooking into a load of chats with a load of Justin Bieber fans if you're a photographer from London. It's just probably not relevant at all. So make sure you're doing that in a constructive way. Don't worry too much about the vanity of how many followers you have. That will come, but certainly use Twitter analytics to measure your impact on Twitter. So that's the first one. The second one, I did a show about this just recently on tagging your URLs, so tagging them with campaigns so that you can measure the impact through Google Analytics. So Google Analytics is the second tool that I would advise that you take a look at. Again, I'll share a link to that video for you so you can see how to tag the URLs. Now, by default, Twitter does pass the campaign tags or the source and the medium tags over to Google Analytics. So if you head into your Google Analytics account, you look at source and medium, social metrics, you should find, hopefully, you're getting traffic from Twitter, and you should see that it's coming through from Twitter, twitter.com, or t.co. T.co is Twitter's URL shortener. So obviously with a tweet, you have limited space. So if you share a big long URL, tillison.co.uk/Google Analytics Training for Beginners, that takes up a heap of space. So what Twitter does is shortens that to a t.co/ small number of characters. When someone clicks that, it redirects to your full URL. So as long as you keep that intact, then Twitter will tell Google Analytics where the traffic is coming from. And that's another metric I would certainly look at to see how much traffic is coming through from Twitter. And I want to see that increasing with the amount of effort and the longer I spend and the bigger my audience becomes. I want to see a return on my investment in Twitter. So the first one, just to summarize, is use Twitter Analytics. And the second one is use Google Analytics and make sure that if you need to, for whatever reason, that you tag those URLs. So make sure you subscribe for more shows on this. If you want that Twitter guide, you're more than welcome to it. It's a fantastic resource. Make sure you click the link and you sign up for that. And make sure you subscribe for more shows, for more tips on how to grow your business online.